Hello and welcome to musclemodelcars.com. Just here to show you today where we are with the 1970 Pontiac Firebird Trans Am that was in the movie with David Carradine, 1976 movie Cannonball. We did the paint job here to kind of resemble as much as we could the vehicle that was in the movie. As you can see, it's very nice paint job on it. We ended up with this blue was a decal, one of two that were in there. We had a white one as well, but the blue correlated with the movie color. So the yellow I had to add to it, and then the paint job we let dry for quite a while. So as you can see, it's a very nice look. And we're moving on. We're about 90% done with it. So the next thing I wanted to show you, you know, we did the chassis. Okay, the interior is blue instead of black. Like in the movie, they had black. And then we just added black accents on the headrest and on the dashboard. And also, this was a decal for the interior right here, for the dashboard. That was a decal, okay? The steering wheel we did in blue, okay, with the steering wheel on the inside there, the ribs of it, a chrome look to it. And then like a stock racing steering wheel. Then with the back of the seats, we did black for a nice, cool look on it, okay? And then we did the door, the size of the door, the latch, and the piping on the side. We did that. Steer column, stick shift in here. And then we did black along the console. Then we decided to go with the the low profile tires instead of these racing stock tires that came. We got two sets of tires. So these were okay, but and they looked nice, and this is the ones that were in the movie, but I chose to go with the 18s, and we got sets of rims to go with this too that came with the kit. As far as the engine wise, we had to put all of it together before we inserted it and painted it. We painted it first, got all the pieces together, and let each part dry before we attached it to the engine block. Red is your air filter, which is over the carburetor, and then the shaker is blue to resemble that in the movie. Okay, so that's where we are with that. These would have been considered like 18s in today's terms, rims, custom rims. Back then, low profile tires on race cars weren't really a thing, but you know. Now you can probably get them off the assembly line like that if you want to pay the money. Then we got the we put the engine valve covers and engine head covers right there, and we installed. You'll see blue down in here on the engine, which is your exhaust manifold right here. We had to put that in before we attached the muffling system, which we attached it back here and let dry. We didn't dry anything else like this drive shaft and the muffling system up here connecting to the outtake manifold. We waited till we let the engine that we mounted inside the chassis dried and into position. And then we also did this while we were letting this, the leaf springs, these are called leaf springs, when we let those dry, we also installed the steering shafts and all the mechanisms that you would see in the front end assembly of your steering. And we let that dry at the same time. Then, once it dried, we connected the red drive shaft to the black engine block underneath up in here. Made sure that it got into position, glued that, let it dry. Then we went on to the exhaust manifold here, that blue, and then attached the black muffling system to it on both sides. Okay, the rear of it has two chrome pipes that haven't been installed yet, and we'll do that once we got everything situated and where we can make sure that we got everything colored, detailed, touched up and everything. Okay, as you can see, the rims and the look of it is clean. Nothing too spectacular about it other than it's real nice and clean. Then we have the radiator up front here. We had to install that, but the thing about it is right up in here, there's no connections to kind of give it any type of sturdiness. So you may have to hold this for a minute or get something to keep it in place to dry, because you don't want it to dry when it's offline or off-centered with your fan. That red fan up in there, it has to be in the middle, because you also have to put your water hoses, upper intake and outtake water hoses, okay? It goes to the engine. We got that. We just haven't installed it yet. We want to let everything dry, and I wanted to show it to you. So, again, this is our rendition of it. As far as the shaker on top in blue, I had to let that be the last installation before we covered it up and dried out. The air filter right down here, which is under the shaker, we had to attach the let that dry to the carburetor, over the carburetor, and the valve covers right here, and the engine block, all of that was assembled and painted before we installed it into the chassis, the gray part of it. Okay, so it looks good. So far, I think we're on the money with it. We only have a few parts left. Like I said, I'm going to show them to you real quick. We did the grill. We're going to end up putting that in black. Okay, just the grill part. We painted the lights white, and then the lower turn signal lights in the front yellow. Okay, these were the spare factory style rims, and these are the, I told you about the chrome pipes to the muffling system coming out the rear end. That's this. These here are mirrors that goes into the mirror inserts, which are going to be installed. That's these two guys right here, and these are the inserts for them right there. Okay, so that's next. Then we got the rear tail lights here. Okay, and those are going to be for, what we did is assembled the bumper, the rear end, and put the license plate in order. Okay. And then we waited till that all dried, and now we're ready to install the tail light that goes right up in here. As you can see, it's going to fit right up in here. Okay, can't really tell, but it'll be like right there. All right. So, but all of it is about being patient and letting it dry. Okay, these are the water hoses. Like I told you, we kind of at the end of this. Pretty good, pretty quick. These are the domes that's going to go over the they're going to go over the headlights right here. Now that I got them painted, I let them dry, and I'm going to cap them now with these. So your front windshield, okay, has visors. I'm going to paint the visors black to match the dashboard. We got a lot of blue already, so I think I'm going to make that black. You got your rear window, okay. You got that going, and these are the other rims for the stock tires that I showed you. These guys here, okay. So they give you both sets. Actually, it'll look like that on the back side. So, what else we have is the decals that's left over. You got plenty of them. Okay, I'm going to use these guys right here, the seat belts, and these can go for another vehicle that I decide to do. Okay, but right now I got a spare box for all the extra stuff that I have. Then you also got these guys, more sponsors type of things that you could put on there, or more decals for the license plate and everything else that could go on there. But for the most part, these here are the lights that could go on the side. There's a location for them, the decals, and even this guy here is for the front. I painted it by hand, but I could have just put the sticker on there. And just like I'm gonna do this one back here, the tail light blinker, I'm going to do that also, but I wanted to make sure the paint dried. And then I do believe we should have everything done by Sunday. Okay, so this is AJ. I wanted to show you where we are so far. Thank you for joining me on this build. Log on to musclemodelcars.com. On YouTube, and then subscribe if you like what you see. See what we've been doing and see where we're going, and talk amongst yourselves and understand that this here is supposed to be fun, but also it's supposed to be relaxing. So don't get stressed out because something fell off or whatever. Just glue it back, take your time, and be patient with it. And you'll have a nice clean look, and you'll also have a nice talking piece with other enthusiasts. Okay, so thank you very much for musclemodelcars.com, and please join us next time we start something. It's going to be a tribute to the I want to say the military. I'm going to do one with respect to that, and then I'm not sure what kind of vehicle, but it's going to be a car, and it's going to be in the line of muscle, okay, for military muscle, okay, and we're going to have a theme with that. So if you guys got one to do one to honor the military, that'd be pretty cool. So that'll be our next one, and we'll go from there. But here you go. This is from the movie Cannonball. Cannonball was an unsanctioned race, not official race. It was a race from New York to California. Any kind of vehicle could enter. The point point was to get there in a timely fashion, and the one with the best time would win. Okay, the pot, the jackpot. So it is, it was, and still is a race that does happen, but law enforcement will be after it. After you, as far as with the speed limits and everything, because it's a time thing, and I think 29 hours is the record, if I'm not mistaken, from New York to California. And any kind of vehicle was in it, and the point was just getting there first, okay? Getting there first driving, not flying your car there, then getting out, then saying I made it first. No, you had to drive it, and they had helicopters or trackers that would watch the routes and the different vehicles to make sure that they weren't doing anything that was too out of the way, out of the pocket, to try to win the jackpot. So that's where we are with this guy here, and this was the one that David Carradine drove. Gentleman that was the actor and the director of Kill Bill, and then Kung Fu, he was in the 70s in that series. He made quite a few, just an actor, he was a producer, he was a performer, he did a lot of things. So, look it up, watch the movie Cannonball. Not Cannonball Run or Cannonball Run 2, but just straight Cannonball, and you should see that vehicle. I think we had it where you could let's see. I'm trying to get to a point where I could show it to you. Here it is, right there. And that's what we're trying to get, that look. If you can see it, that's what we're looking for, okay? And so we got a couple of minor things to do, but for the most part, I think we nailed it pretty good. As I said before, the blue was a decal, and you had an option with a white one if you wanted to do the kit that was on the box. But also you had the yellow one. The yellow was on the movie vehicle, so I had to be creative with getting the yellow striped in, and then to make it look like the vehicle. Okay, and then I also changed the wheels, the rims, because I kind of wanted to see these on it, and instead of the factory stock version. So we'll see you next time, and it'll be complete, and we'll show it and see how you like it. Okay. All right, so thank you for joining MuscleModelCars.com, and don't forget, join us on YouTube, look at some of the things we've done, and hit the subscribe button. Okay, thank you.